start a demo is to get the customer to touch and feel the telescope so they get a handle on how heavy it is. I then unscrew the eyepiece and tube so that people can see the inside of the telescope. I then show the push rods so that the customer can understand how these are controlled by the micrometers. And finally, show them the rack and pinion, which is connected to the focusing drum. This picture shows a schematic of the telescope and the optics that are in it. Explain the importance of cylindrical grinding and how it's important that the focusing cell moves up and down the tube in a straight line. Alignment is 80% of the work that we do, and now we're going to go through a typical alignment setup. I would normally do an alignment with two glass targets. You could use one, but I think two is better. You can explain that the rings on the target are actually calibrated rings. So now what we need to do is set a line of sight through two points. A lot of the accessories are based around spheres. The reason for this is that if you rotate or tilt a sphere, the center remains in the same place. For most of the telescope setups, I would use the horizontal base. Note the sphere in this setup. For training purposes, I also tend to use the CCTV camera. It just makes life much easier for all the attendees to easily see what's happening. As well as the horizontal base, you could mount the telescope in a bore fixture or on a Unimount or tripod. There are a whole host of accessories that we can help you with at Spectrum. For mounting the target, we have the adjustable target holder, spider fixture, and flange cup with sphere. We normally offer the bullring style targets, but there are different patterns for different jobs. Contact Spectrum for details on the different patterns. The key thing is the parallelism of the target. We have both 2-second and 20-second targets. 20-second targets being a greeny colour and 2 seconds being a clear colour. With a 2-second target, you could get a maximum of 1 second refraction, and with the 20-second target, you could get 10 seconds. An important number for you is that 1 second is approximately 5 microns per meter. So if you happen to leave a 20-second target in place, you could get an error of 50 microns per meter. With every target, there is a small card inside the target box which explains accuracy and diameter of each one of the rings. So now, to set a line of sight through 2 points, there is a very specific rule. You look at the far target, you tilt the telescope up and down and left and right. When you look at the front target, you displace up and down, left and right. So now you have a reference line through the front target and through the back target. We normally then move the front target along the slideway and seeing how far it's been displaced up and down, left and right. This displacement can be measured with just the micrometer drum, which have plus or minus 1.2 millimeters, or a combination of the micrometer drum and the rings on the target. A useful convention to stop any confusion about what's plus and what's minus is the LERD convention. So for this convention, L left, U up, R right, D down. So before we take a serious reading, let's put the micrometer drums on the telescope to the zero position, and let's remove parallax out of the eyepiece. And if you are using the adjustable target holders, you must make sure that they are matched. That means they're both the same height. Quite easy to do. Point the telescope at one of the targets, zero it, and then move the other target and zero that as well. To recap, the rules before you start a measurement. Decide whether you want a 2-second or 20-second target. Check the mics are set to zero and check for parallax. If you're using adjustable target holders, make sure the targets are matched. Don't forget to use the LERD convention And always remember, displace on the front target, tilt on the back target. There are a whole host of other accessories to measure flatness, squareness. Use the MAT as an autocollimator. But we'll talk about that another time. Thank you very much for listening. Contact Spectrum if you have any issues, any applications in alignment. Mm-hmm.